Hi everyone, Assalamualaikum. I'm Bern from Oil and Gas Business Division of Chemopharm Group. So welcome to Chemopharm channel. Today I would like to introduce one of the standard method that we can use in distillation of atmospheric distillation. So what we call is as a D7345. I know everyone in this industry know about this standard method. This is the alternative method to determine the atmospheric distillation for your petroleum and also the liquid fuel product, or what we call as a micro distillation method. Okay, let's continue with the a few specification that we have to certify our fuel. For example, D3946 for fuel oil, D975 for diesel fuel, and also the D4814 for gas oil. Actually, this is the specification that we have. Inside this fuel specification, actually got mentioned the D86 as a referee method, and we have another method which is alternative. So for D7345, it is mentioned in each fuel specification. As you can see on the screen, there is a specification of the fuel and also the referee method and the alternative method. So all the specification got include D7345 as an alternative method. So one of the specification, if you can see, is a biodiesel product. Generally, D86 is not recommended to use for biodiesel because the biodiesel sample actually it will decompose when we distill under the atmospheric pressure. In fact, the distillation for the biodiesel need to be done under the reduced pressure. But when we are using the D7345, the distillation can easily be done, and then it can produce the accurate result. Basically, PAC developed a new product to comply to the D7345. We call it as an OptiPMD. Okay, this is OptiPMD. Today, I want to share a few interesting facts about the OptiPMD compared to the previous D86. Okay, so for the firstly, as I mentioned just now, the D7345, which is OptiPMD, it is comply to the biodiesel fuel specification, so that you can use it to determine the distillation of the biodiesel product, whereby the D86 is not recommended to use. Okay, so for the second fact is, we only using a very small amount of sample, which is only we require 10 ml sample. So we just put 10 ml into this flask and then put back on the instrument. We choose the method and then we can start to run the equipment. Actually, it will take is around 10 minutes to complete the distillation. So it can reduce the analysis time compared to the OptiDIS, which is D86, is around 25 to 35 minutes. Okay, the last part I want to share is, I know everyone using the D86, so you required to know the group of your hydrocarbon sample, which is, for example, the group 1 and 2, it is required the base plate 38 mm, and then for the group 3 and 4, it is required 50 mm base plate. Okay, so for the OptiPMD, actually you no need to know which group of your samples belong to, because when you put the sample in the flask and then you start to run the analysis, the equipment itself, they will detect the sample behavior from the first distillation occur, and then it will set the right heating rate. So this is why OptiPMD is not required to change any plate. So you can straight away run the equipment. Okay, so before I end the video, let me recap back what I talked just now. Okay, firstly, actually D7345 is a perfect correlation to D86 method and also D1160 and ISO 3405 and also the IP123. So you can use it as an alternative method to determine the atmospheric distillation. Okay, the secondly is D7345. Actually, it is included in at least 10 fuel specification, including from fuel spec from Canada, from Mexico, from UK, from India, and so on. Okay, so the next is you need to remember OptiPMD. You need to remember is a triple 10. I call it as a triple 10, which is first is 10 ml sample. And then the secondly is it is required only 10 minutes to complete the distillation. And then it is included in at least 10 fuel specification. Okay, I hope today's video will help you to understand more about D7345. So we catch up in the next coming video for another sharing. So see you, bye bye.